Hello everyone, my name is Jamie Sondra and today I'm gonna teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. It is an old hut in the mountain with some rocks, grasses, and a river. And please don't forget to subscribe if you have subscribed it and hit that bell button if you want to receive some future notification of my new videos and tutorials. Okay everyone, so you can see all the materials needed on the screen. You can see there the 5 limited colors, the brushes I'm gonna need, and other things that we're gonna need to paint this painting or this tutorial. Okay, so I'm going to start now, and I'm gonna do first on the sketching. We need to do this always because it's very important everyone to start with the planning, which is a sketching, before gonna start everything else like under painting. Okay, so I have here the raw umber, and then I'm gonna put some white. It will make it lighter in color and it will be easy for us to blend. No, I mean, I'm sorry, it's easy for us to cover it with other colors. Okay, there. And I'm gonna put some very slope mountain here. Yeah, actually I get this photo from the Pixabay, and I'm going to put the owner of the photo on the description box. I'm gonna put the house here. Yeah, something like this. I'll put a little smaller. Yeah, we have we can adjust later on what will be or what are we going to adjust, just to make it look better. So we can feel free to retouch later on. So there will be some houses here and also a river. It will be just a small river. Okay, and on here we're gonna put some mountain ranges. It will be some rocky mountain with some snow there. Okay, I will not copy everything what I saw there on the photo. I'll just copy what I can copy. You don't have to make it perfect. Just make it look real. Okay, just follow the pattern what you see there. Okay, so I'm going to start now, and we're gonna do the underpainting first. I'm gonna do here. I have here the blue color, and then some red and umber, and then white. I'm gonna add a little white to make it a little lighter, and then a little water. Yeah, I think that's enough. It should be lighter, everyone. Not so dark because it's far, and object will become lighter when it's farther. There should be some rocky mountain here. Thank you. there. Make it a little lighter. This will be a really beautiful great mountains on the background. Okay, I'll try to put a little more here. Okay, so I will be using this raw umber with blue color. It will be more on raw umber, everyone. And then some white to make it lighter. I think I will put some red. No, I think more blue. Some more umber. Now it should be, yeah, I think I'll put red and blue. I'm gonna put the raw umber later on, but I'm gonna put more white. Yeah, I think this is perfect color. Not too dark, but it should be bluish. Okay, so I'm going to put a little more brownish or bluish gray color here. Okay, there. Sorry, everyone, someone messaged me. Yeah, I think I need to. Okay, yeah, there are plenty of distractions. Sorry, everyone. Okay, so I'll just continue putting it here. Okay, I'm going to use again this raw umber with some blue and red. It should be more brownish, everyone, and then white. Okay, again I'm gonna put, gonna mix. Okay. I'm going to add more. I'm going to add more blue. Blue umber and white. Okay, everyone, sorry, there are really some plenty of distractions here. Okay, so I'm going to add more dark here. So this is the second step yet, adding some underpainting. I think this canvas is not so stretched. Okay. I'm gonna put a little dark here. More darker. But my problem is my canvas, okay? There, so I'm going to add some yellowish here or some orange color on this field. This is a field here, but beautiful field. Yellow and red. So we just have to fill this part with some yellowish color, just a mixture of yellowish, blue, or red to make it more bright in color. Now, underpainting is very important also.
there. Okay, yeah, and then I'm going to add more here, some, but I'm gonna use a smaller brush. Yeah, again, some yellowish, greenish color. Okay, and then I'm gonna use some purple, blue, and red, and then white. I'm gonna put some color on the water. It will be a little lighter. Then I'm gonna make this dark using the planes for umber. Okay, so I am done with the second step, everyone, which is the underpainting. Yeah, maybe I still need to put some clouds there, but I'm gonna do it later on when I put the underpainting here. Okay, I'm gonna put now, because I think really gonna need to put some colors on the clouds. Yeah, I forgot. Can put some white there. Can put some purple. Yeah, it's a little cloudy this time, so expect to put some plenty of So everyone, there are plenty of kids playing in the outside. Okay. Renovate it a little one to make it to spread the colors. Okay, so yeah, I'm done with the underpainting, and I think I'm gonna let it dry a little, but I'm not sure. Yeah, I'm gonna let it dry a little one, but I'm not sure. Yeah, I'll just continue. And the next step will be adding some more details now. Yeah. I'll try to put some bluish top on this mountain. Yeah, but you can also use the spray, everyone. If you want to make it wet, it's better. Then it's fine now. So I have here the blue and the white. Then this part here, I'm gonna put some bluish part. Yeah, maybe I think you can put it later on because it's hard, it's still wet. Okay, yeah, and then I'm going to try to put some details on these mountains, but we're gonna mix it first, blue umber and a little red. I'll use a smaller brush. will start it here. It should be bluish. I can put a little tiny details here. Just that, everyone. Just a tiny dots. There. Okay, yeah. And then also here. Just use the tapping technique, but don't overdo it. Always remember that. There. And then also here. So everyone, our place is really, really noisy. 20 people shouting. Yeah, it's normal here. Okay. And then also here. Just put like that. Just tapping technique, everyone. Slowly by slowly it will become to look realistic. Okay, yeah, I think that looks better. It looks pretty good in the little distance. Yeah, I'm going to mix for a little lighter. Darker. So purple, blue, and red. More red, and then white. This time around it should be a little darker. I think it will take time, but we need to take time also. It's very important to keep time. You don't have to copy everything from the photo. You just have to know the pattern like that, and the exact color you're gonna put there. By doing that, it will look realistic in the distance. Okay. And also here. Okay, yeah, I think that would be enough. I think those mountains really look great. So far, I love these mountains. Really look realistic. Yeah. Yeah, looks like a mountain range. Okay, I'm going to proceed here. This will be much more brownish, but you can also see some grayish color for this mountain. It will be some cliffs or something like that, some rocks. So we need to put it also. We still need to put some big pine tree here, but I'm gonna put it later. So careful, everyone, when you put the details there. We might cover some parts. There. Okay. I will be using again the number 8 little pot brush, and then this umber with white. Yeah, I can try this one with a little yellow. I think we're gonna need to put some yellow here. Okay, umber with white. Umber with yellow and white. This will be some plenty of slopes here, plenty of details. Okay, yeah. Okay, some viewers have been there. Nice outside. Maybe I need to reshape my studio. Ma, ini sih siapa sih? Wah. Okay. So I'm going to add more. Highlights here. I'll be putting more lights here, everyone. Yeah, and more also here. There. Yeah, okay. And then I'm going to add some white. Yeah, I think I'm gonna use smaller. Okay, I think that will be enough. Yeah, I think it's not look like with the original from the photo, but for me it looks great. It looks awesome. And it looks realistic. Okay, so I'm going to add more here. Same with that. Okay. I'm going to add some lights here. Okay, I'm gonna use some brown, raw umber, and white. Here, I'm gonna put some more brownish here. Okay, so I'm going to add some more brownish here to make it look more realistic. Yeah, I think this looks good, everyone. Also here, I think I'm gonna put some more brownish here. Make sure everyone always remember this, that those colors here, like the brownish color or anything, it should be lighter than the background color, or else something really not good to see. Yeah, I'm gonna put some pathway here. I don't know what's this, but it looks like a pathway. Okay, that looks good. And then I'll be using my bristle path brush. Yellow and blue. Yeah, so like a yellow and blue one. I'm gonna put a red. Should be not so bright. And then we can put some pine trees here. Some trees in the forest. Okay, you can use the tapping technique like that. Let's use this bristle path brush, everyone. There. I want it to be more dark. Okay. So everyone. Okay. I'm gonna put more greens here. there. Yeah, just add more everyone, just add more textures like this. Actually, I can do it one by one, but it can be, it will be take time to do it. Okay. Okay, I'll add more. I'm just glazing everyone. Okay. Yeah, I think that looks good. Okay. Looks, I really like the beautiful. Okay, I'm gonna use this again, and I'm gonna add more retouch here. Okay. Then I'm gonna put more blue, red, no, not yellow one, but for umber. Okay, I think this looks good. Okay, everyone, I'm gonna do it first here before I'm gonna completely retouch on this part. Yellow and white. Okay, I'm gonna mix for a little brownish color. I'm gonna put it here. Oh, this will be some grassland here on the distance, everyone. I think that looks good. I'm gonna use this blue umber and a little blue. Umber and blue. Oh, with a little red. Just make it this part a little lighter, everyone. Yeah. Okay, yeah. It's a river on the distance. Yeah, I think that looks pretty good. Okay, so I'm gonna proceed now here. I'm not gonna waste my time on this field here. Yeah, but I think I will put first some pine trees on the back of the house. Okay, I have here some blue, blue umber, and yellow. And here we're gonna put some pine tree, so it's just a topping, everyone. Plenty of children playing outside. Hopefully it doesn't distract everyone. It's a little distraction for me, but yeah, I need to continue. And also here, I need to put some darker tones for the grasses. I think I'm gonna put more yellow and red. There. Okay. I'll use the bigger brush. Yeah, I'll find some bristle for brush. Okay, still the same. I'll put more yellow. And red and white. Yeah, I can do it a little slowly, everyone. Make sure that the glass should be smaller. You can actually use a fan brush here for this part. There. Okay, I'm gonna put more yellowish color or orange color. I'm gonna put it here. We just have to do this like this one. Okay. Yeah. Actually, this really looks realistic for me. Okay, I'm gonna put some rocks there, plenty of rocks. I'll be using this umber. Yeah, and then using that, I'm gonna put some white. Plenty of rocks here, so we just have to do it, make it look like an abstract. There, and in here. Okay, we just have to put the grey first before we're gonna put those rocks. Those highlights, I mean. These are rocks actually. Okay, then we're gonna put some lighter colors, lighter gray. Yeah, so you just have to put it on the top, everyone. Okay, and then I will use a smaller brush, and then I will use some pure white. Yeah. there will be plenty of rocks there on this side. Always remember everyone that farther will be, should be smaller. And then you have to put also some dark shades. As in this umber. Ah, there will be plenty of rocks here, everyone. Okay. You don't have to make it perfect. You just have to follow the patterns. Make it look like those rocks and something like that. It will actually form in the distance when you see it. Okay. Yeah, I think for now it will be good. I do not need to make it as perfect as possible. I need to put some white. I just have to put some more details. Yeah, just white thing around, just white highlights and When you see it in the distance, it will become realistic. And also here. Just put some different shapes here and become, when you see in the distance, it will become better. Okay, yeah, that will be good. Yeah, well, it's time to create the house. I will be using the gray here. Center and then here. You can actually use the liner brush if you. It will be hard for you using this brush. Put some details like this. Yeah. And then I want this raw umber with yellow to be a little lighter raw umber. And then I'll put it like this, horizontal. Yeah. And then here on the inside, there are some woods there, details for that. Okay, that looks good. And then I'm going to use a smaller brush. Yeah, I'm gonna use the liner brush now. This is umber. Darker than raw umber. Okay. Then I'm gonna use some white. I'm gonna put it in the top. Okay. There. Yeah, I think that looks good, everyone. I also like the background, and also looks pretty good. It looks pretty realistic for me. Yeah. And then I'm going to, yeah, I'm going to add some more retouch. I'm going to add some more, small houses there on the distance. I'll just use this light gray. And like that. Just tiny white patches, and it will become house in the distance. Okay, just like that, everyone. And then I'm gonna put some colors on these pine trees using the bristle brush. Put it on the left side. There. Oh, I'm in right side, everyone. I really don't know why it's in the right side, but maybe in the highlights, maybe on the top. Yes. And then white, yellow and white. Just tapping, everyone, tapping technique, and then it's a big look. Okay. Okay, there. And then I'm going to add more here. And also here. Thank you. And then I'll try to put some of the pine trees on the top. Okay, and then the last part here, everyone, I'm going to retouch and then I'm done. Yeah, I just put more. Just stopping everyone. Grasses. I'm gonna refine those grasses here. Make it look better. There. I am using the flat brush, everyone, not the bristle flat brush. Just a flat brush, nylon. Can also use synthetic. Yeah, so yeah, I think I am done, everyone. So I am contented with the entire result. I will not put many more details because I think that will be good for a tutorial or for the beginners. So yeah, it's 1 hour and 27 minutes. It's almost 1 hour and 30 minutes, and so far it will really look great. Okay, everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.